Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to my channel. I'm such an unserious person, you see. But you guys, thank you so much for clicking on whatever link you clicked on that got you here. Thank you so much for you guys watching. Today I'm gonna be doing a chicha makeup tutorial, and I'm sure you've already seen the description below, so I hope you guys enjoy watching. So obviously the most important question, like, Ade, where have you been? Like, what have you been doing? Like, why did you just leave YouTube like that? Whew, girl, boy, whoever's watching, grab some tea, you know. Actually, it's actually not that deep. Just carry on what you're doing, and if you want to listen to me talk, well. So anyway, my foundation, I'm using 430. Actually, my skin tone is actually 420, but I bought this during the summer, so it's actually slightly darker than me, but when I put everything on, everything seems to come together. And I actually don't even use too much of this foundation, to be honest. Like, I just use like 3 pumps of it and I'm good to go. So anyway, so why did I leave YouTube? Well, it's a mix of a lot of things. I think like sometime last year, I kind of had a dip in my self-confidence. I mean, it went on for a while, and honestly speaking, this has been a long summer of discovering myself again, learning to love myself again, and so many other things. And to be very honest, I feel like a lot of these feelings that we have of not being very self-confident, it has to do a lot with the kind of people we surround ourselves with. Like, someone told me one time that you're a sum total of the 5 people you hang out with the most. So like, if you hang around toxic people, you're gonna start becoming toxic at some point. Like, you can go around telling everybody that this person is toxic and that person is toxic, but the truth is, the more you hang out with them, you're gonna become like them very, very, very soon. But yeah, and you guys can see that this foundation is slightly darker than me. Like, if you look at my face and my neck, you can see it. And I usually don't put on too much foundation. Like, I just go for medium coverage, because when I put on everything just comes together, you know, concealers and all of that. So anyway, Sham, let me just put this aside. So yeah. Whew. But anyway, I had a dip in my self-confidence, and then I was going through this period where I was really, really broke. And right now, I am filming my video with my iPhone 7. And I used to film with my Canon 600D, 300D. I don't even remember. I think it was 300D or something like that. No, 1300D. That's what I was using. Yeah, the concealer I'm using is Latte Fenty Beauty as well. So I bought a camera for like £400. It came with an extra pair of lens. So I used to film with that, and then I had to sell my camera at some point because I was so broke. I was really, really broke. I had so many bills to pay, you know? Just had to do what I had to do. Yeah, so you guys, I still use Sasha Buttercup, Sasha. I don't know how, but whichever one you want to call it. I still use it to set my concealer. You're not gonna be, this is the same one I bought in 2015. This thing doesn't want to finish. So what was I saying? Yes, so I had to sell my camera. and you know, pay bills and all of that. And funny thing is, I've had this iPhone 7 for a long time, and I've had all my equipment, like tripod, everything, but you know, when personally I feel like a lot of times when we're so, when we lose our confidence in something, any excuse we can get to not do it, we'll be very, very happy to do it, because we'll be very happy to get an excuse. Because I could have, when I saw my camera, I could have started filming my phone, but the excuse I kept telling myself was, oh, I don't have my camera, so there's no point, I don't have anything to film, I'm using espresso for my contour. So I stopped filming and everything. I think my last video was December. And honestly, I'm taking those videos from before, all the videos before this, I'm taking them down, because I feel like I am not the same person in those videos. Like, I have grown as a woman. I am more confident than I was back then. And looking at that person, I feel like this is not me. And this is also the Fenty concealer and contour brush. I feel like that's not me anymore. And even when I watch them, I'm just like, who is this person? Like, I'm not this girl anymore. That girl sounded like she wasn't very confident in herself, like she didn't love herself a lot. So this summer, yeah, when I went to Nigeria earlier this summer after my exams. I went June to July. While I was in Nigeria, I started applying for jobs again and all of that, applying for summer jobs, you know, because I was like, I'm gonna come back to England and then what next? Like, what am I gonna be doing? But ooh, look at my nose. Would I just be sitting down like in my house doing nothing? Like, even to enjoy your summer, my wig is coming off. We'll sort you out later. It's like, even to enjoy your summer now, you need money if you're going to be doing wakadugo around. So yeah, I came back to, I started applying from Nigeria. I applied, though nobody wants to give me a job. Nobody wants to give me a job. All jobs I applied to, I was doing like, I'll go on Indeed. Almost everything I saw, I'll apply. So yeah, I came back to England, yeah. Came back with quite some money. When I came back, my church had a program. So during that period when I was back, no, the period leading up to when I came back to England, I told myself that I think I really, really want to get my relationship with God back on track. So I started praying. I started reading my Bible a lot. Like, I'm not a prayer warrior like that though. But when it comes to reading my Bible, I feel like that is God's way of speaking to us. Like, it's very easy for us to say that, oh, God is not talking to us, that you don't know how to hear God's voice, but your Bible is just there and it's closed. So, you know, I started reading my Bible a lot. I decided to start from the book of Matthew. Like, they usually tell you start from John, but why I started from Matthew was because I really wanted to know who Jesus was. That was what I was really interested in at the time. So I started reading it. I started Matthew, and I got so hooked on it. So the point that sometimes, some days when I don't read it, I'll feel like there's something missing in my life. You know how you feel like you're having withdrawal symptoms from something that you're so used to? That was how I used to feel when I didn't read my Bible. And honestly, I liked that feeling because I started to realize that I need to be totally dependent on God. I really like this contour, especially with the brush, like it just blends so well. I think this Fenty line is just amazing because if you're even that expensive, I mean, for Rihanna, it's not that expensive. So anyway, my church had a program, I think it's called Summer Praise. So there's lots of singing and most of my friends know I'm in the choir. So when I got back, I was busy with that. Then after that, I was like, okay, so now what am I gonna be doing? I was at home, and then one day I just decided, oh, I wanted to check up on my friend. I called her and she was like, oh, she's registered with this agency. I was like, oh, what agency is that? She told me her job and told me how much she was making weekly. I was like, oh, that, what agency is that? She told me their name. I was like, wait, I know these people, that they're also here in Bristol. So, you know, that night, I quickly applied to them. Next day, I got a call. They're like, oh, are you available for an interview? I was like, yes. Then I got there and they were like, oh, that the only jobs available now is cleaning jobs, like be a cleaner. Like, to me, it was like cleaner. Wow, okay. I can't lie, I was feeling very proud. So, you know how cleaners are in Nigeria now. You know, I was feeling very, very proud of her. Me, wash toilets. I don't know. So I like to set my powder with this face hydrating mist from Body Shop, because I have very dry skin. So I'm just gonna let this set and then I'll start my eyes. So like, I was like, ha, you'll be a cleaner. I prayed about it. God was like, you've been asking for a job, like, humble yourself and do this thing. So okay, I'm just going to go ahead and be a cleaner. So that was that. Started the job. When they told me how much they were paying, I was like, what, me making this money from being a cleaner? I'll not tell you guys how much, but from that experience, like, I really realized that in some situations you gotta do what you gotta do. Like, it's only temporary, to be honest. Like, I'm a student, I'm not gonna do that for the rest of my life. I wasn't planning on doing that all summer, but at that moment I really needed money. So I'm using espresso right now on my eyes because most of these sticks are multi-usage. So I'm just using it on my eyes. Yeah. And then next I'm gonna use rum. I'm just gonna put it directly on my eyes. So yeah, guys. So then again came the problem of, oh, where is the job? They told me the job is in Bath. I was like, Bath, all the way in Bath, University of Bath. It's like, so I'm going to have to get a bus every day because train is more expensive. So it's a cheaper option. I'm trying to make money here, not waste more money. So, you know, I live not too far from bus station, so. It's like, okay, I'll get the bus every day. So every morning I'll wake up at 7, 1.5 journey to University of Bath. Got it every single 5 days a week. Some days I even did 6 because, you know, extra money. So some weeks I did 6 days. So anyway, Shan, I'll get back home at like 7. I think when I came back from Nigeria, I was really obsessed with personal growth, like just being better, doing better for myself. That I just really, really wanted to love myself. So, you know, I'll come back and a lot of you guys on my Snapchat will see me go to the gym like right after work. So like, after I had done a full day of work and been on the road for 3 hours, spent 3 hours commuting back and forth, I will now go to the gym. And I enjoyed it. I was really feeling myself. Like, come on, check on my muscles. Whew, it was worth it. But yeah, like, I really, really liked it. Like, I just kept myself so busy with that. So guys, I just used Trophy Wife on my eyes. And then I'm going back with espresso. So yeah, you know, I did that for a month. By the end of that month, I was like, I made over £1,000 just from that. I was able to sort myself out, pay any outstanding bills I had, any overdraft. For some reason, it's like money adds to people's self-confidence. I can't even lie, because I am money. You feel like nobody can tell you nonsense, man. There's some nonsense you won't take from anybody. And yeah, that's how we felt. And I think what even felt really, really good was, I felt like I did this for me. Like, I got up, I did this job. I was very proud of myself after that. And it was a very humbling experience because during that job, some days I'll be on my way home and I would, you know, when you're being stubborn and you eat something and you litter the road, I'm like, I'll go back and I'll pick it up because I'm like, someone is gonna have to clean this up. So yeah, that job was a humbling experience for me. I met some amazing people. It was really, really good. Like, I met people of all sorts of backgrounds. It was fun. It was quite, I felt sad like leaving them. But yeah, it was a good experience. After that, I got another job. This one was much better. I got another job in another agency. It was a beauty job, so it was like, I went up, like I moved up, and y'all know that I love beauty, so doing makeup on people, I was really excited to go to work every day, oh my god. And best part about this one, it's a 10-minute walk from my house, so it was so comfortable, it was just right. And it was just like, after a month of humbling myself and doing this other job, like, God just blessed me with this one. Because like, the day I quit my job, my old job, my cleaning job, I got offered the next one. But I really, really felt like God was thinking about me. Like, this summer, I have really understood the love of God. Like, if you really understand how much God loves you, you would know that nobody can mess with you because God takes you so seriously. If somebody messes with you, they're looking for trouble with God, because God doesn't play with his kids. Like, he doesn't. And you're a child of God and you should recognize that. But yeah, I mean, life has been good so far. I'm back at uni and everything, and this is my third year at uni, and it's going great so far, so good. I mean, I know it's gonna get a bit stressful soon, but I have learned to just be grateful in every situation, because some people are not at uni, some people are struggling, some people want to be going to school. So I would rather sit here and, you know, deal with the stress of uni than complain that, oh, uni is stressing me, oh my god, oh, this and that. So like, I really learned to be thankful in so many situations. And most of all, yeah, I realized that a lot of times when we get depressed, we need to look at the people around us. And I said this earlier in my video, but let me be clear on this. When you recognize that someone isn't good for your life, and trust me, it's not only, because most of the times when you're talking to someone, you're telling them, when you recognize someone isn't good for your life, they think everything is all boyfriend, girlfriend. Some friends should not be in your life. Some friends, watch the kind of friends you keep. Watch those ones that talk to you like you're a child, that undermine you, that talk to you like you don't know anything, that try to guilt trip you into doing things. I tell my friends a lot that feeling in your chest is not there for anything. You know when a situation is wrong, you know when this person isn't wrong, and you need to take it upon yourself to walk away from situations that don't serve you, that don't add to your growth. Because guess what? The only person you can blame is yourself when things don't work out. So I'm not gonna put on any lashes. I'm using, well, I'm sure some of you know, I never do. Oh my god. So I'm gonna use my L'Oreal eyeliner, which is one of my favorites. Like, I've been using this for like 4 years now. Yeah, this is alright, I guess. And then I'm gonna use this mascara by Clinique, High Impact Mascara. I got this in a goodie bag at House of Fraser like last year, and I really like it. Like, it's a tester, Abby. No, it's sample size rather. That's what they call it. But when this is done, like, I'm gonna buy the full size, cause this thing is really, really, really good. So yeah, I really love this mascara. The way I love my eyes, man, it's crazy. I really, really, really love my eyes. I'm gonna just top this up because it got a stain in the process. Yeah. And then, guys, I'm gonna go in with my Trophy Wife highlight. This has quickly become my favorite highlighter in the world, honestly. I wear this thing like almost every day. Yep. And then I'm gonna take the little that's here and blend it with our old reliable Gold Deposit by MAC. I'm putting on my hair. I really hear. Mackie Beats Bear. Hey. And then, oh my god, my favorite part. This spray just makes my entire face to pop. So. How do I look? Ooh. Look at my highlight. Look at my highlight. Okay, guys, something is worrying me. And finally, my gloss bomb. This lip gloss is everything. Honestly, I kid you not. When I tell you guys, something is worrying me. So thank you guys for listening to me talk. Please remember to like, subscribe. Tell your friend to tell her friend to tell her sister's friend. But yeah, you guys, please stick around, subscribe to my channel, and I'm gonna have more stuff for you guys in due time. I'm gonna do my best to upload every week from now on. Like, I need to be loyal to you guys. You guys are loyal to me, you know. This is a two-way relationship. Thank you so much for watching my video. I love you guys. Have an amazing rest.